Welcome to another video tutorial. In this video, I will tell you that how we can design primers for cloning your gene of interest into any vector. So you can see here someone has asked that how we can design primers for cloning this gene into Pickambia 2300, and purpose for this cloning was subcellular localization. So actually we know that there are many vectors which are commercially available. You can see here is a list of vectors which are commercially available in the markets in the different biotechnological companies. So among them, they want to use Pickambia 2300 for subcellular localization. And we know that usually the selection of any vector depends on our purpose. But to coming back to this specific question, let me try to answer this question. So for the solution of this, we should have following thing. First, we should have the CDS sequence of this gene. First, we should have the CDS sequence of this gene. And number two, we should have this sequence of that vector. And in this case, because they have asked to use Pickambia 2300, we can just copy paste this one. And number three, we should have a tool to design these primer. So in this example, I will use CE clone express entry primer designing tool. Entry primer design tool. Actually, this tool has recently been published by Vzyme company. So we will use these three things to design primers for this gene cloning into Pickambia vector. So let me take you to the Google and collect first this gene sequence, then we will collect the vector sequence, and then we will use this tool to design primers for cloning. So here is Google. First of all, we have to get the sequence of that gene. So let me, because that this gene, we can see here, this gene belongs to the OS mean Oryza sativa, although we can get its sequence from NCBI, but I will get its sequence from Rice database. So similarly, you can get your gene sequence from any database. So I will get its sequence from Rice database. So let me paste this gene ID here. Yeah, here is this gene. We can try to get its CDS sequence. We can click here to get CDS. You can see here is the genomic sequence, and here is its CDS sequence. So it means we have now retrieved the CDS sequence. So on the second step, we should have a sequence of vector. So now we will open NCBI to get the sequence of that vector. We can, for this, we can open NCBI, and from here we can search this drop down list and go to nucleotide. Yeah, here is nucleotide, and we will search that vector, that is Pickambia 2300. Okay, so we will search this. You can see here we have retrieved the binary vector Pickambia 2300, its complete sequence. You can see here this vector has 8701 nucleotides in its sequence. So now we can download this FASTA sequence by clicking on this. You can see here is the sequence of that Pickambia 2300. So far now we have retrieved the CDS sequence of that gene, and we have also retrieved the sequence of it can be a vector. Now we need this clone express entry primer designing tool, so we can simply copy this keywords and open Google. So you can paste just this one here. So you can see here the first link, primer design for clone express entry. You can click on this one. The first link, you can see here, it has opened that cloning express designing tool. This was designed by Vzyme company. And here is single fragment cloning and here is multiple fragment cloning. Because we are using single fragment cloning, so I will click on this. And after that, we have to select that whether you are linearizing your vector using single restriction enzymes or double restriction enzymes. I usually use double restriction enzymes, although I will make a separate video that how we can choose non-cutter enzymes for during cloning process. But for this video, it is beyond the scope of this video, so I will just use this double restriction enzyme digestion. So here you can see here, please enter the complete sequence of cloning vector. So here is the vector sequence. We can just simply copy this vector sequence and paste into that tool. I have just copied here. Here is the vector sequence. And here we need to select the 5' restriction enzyme that is non-cutter. And here we have to select the 3' 9-cutter. So this thing I will cover in a separate video. So you can, for me, I was using SAL1 and BAM-H1. So let me try to find SAL1. Yeah, SAL1. Yeah, SAL1 and BAM-H1. Yeah, this one. So these were non-cutter for my gene of interest. And here you can see, here we have pasted the sequence of vector. Here we will paste the sequence of our gene of interest. So you know that we have already retrieved the CDA sequence of our gene of interest. So we will simply copy this sequence and paste into this. But it is important to note that because we are putting this gene of interest into a round plasmid, so we don't need this TGA, which is the usually stop codon. So I have removed this TGA as stop codon. So now we can simply click on this generate CE2 amplification primers. So it is just showing the message that GC content of recombinant sequence is more than 70%. It's okay. So here you can see we have obtained 2 primers. So we will simply just copy these primers here. And this is the forward primer and this is reverse primer. Now we can use these primers for our cloning purpose. So I will call them long primers. Although you can use these long primer directly for your cloning, but if you face difficulty in amplification, then first you can use short primers and clone your fragment separately. So I will recommend you, if you are not getting amplification, then you can use short primers first. So how to find that short primers? You can see here, first you can only clone the fragment. So this is the forward primer for fragment and this is the reverse primer for fragment. So you can see here are few nucleotides which are mentioned in capital and few are mentioned in the small letters. The small letters are referring to the insert, so we can order this forward primer. This is forward primer and similarly this is reverse primer. So now our primers are ready. And we can order our primers through any company and start our cloning process. Hopefully in this way you can also design your primers and start cloning of your gene of interest for any of your purpose. Hopefully you will like the video. If you have any question, please let me know in the comment section. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.